Let's now take a look at each individual note. So we have E minor 7 flat 5. That first note is E, so that's definitely going to be our 1. That F is actually F natural. So in this tune, we're actually in the key of F major, so with 1 flat. You can think of it as F major or D Aeolian minor. All right, so that F natural is our flat 9, or you can call it flat 2, whatever it is. That G is flat 3. Now we're in A7 flat 9 land, and that A is 1, that, remember, key in B flat, key of F major, so that B flat is our flat 9. Call it the flat 2 if you want. Now, instead of C sharp in that A7 flat 9, we have C natural here. So what that is a sharp 9, or you can call that a flat 3. It's the same thing. Last note is D, which is our 4, or you can call that our 11. Now next we're in D minor 7 land. E is 9, G is 4 or 11, D is of course 1, F natural is our flat 3, E is 9, and then he plays us a natural 6, or we can call that a 13. And then last we have A, which is our 5th. So this is our very specific analysis using scale degrees. Now, let's take a bird's eye view and see what we can look at a broader sense. So I'm going to erase this here. I'm going to erase that. And let's look at it a different way. Now, if you have a different way of looking at it, put down in the comments your analysis, and then we can take a look and talk about it. So what I see here is that he's mainly playing in the key. He's mainly just harmonically generalizing F major until we get to, let me change another color, until we get to this B natural here. You can even think about this in D minor Aeolian, which is also called natural minor, and he throws in that B natural, which then kind of signals that we're in Dorian minor, or maybe a F major with a sharp 11. So you can think about it both ways.